Hey, what's going on, guys? So I know we're in the middle of a pandemic. Well, I hope we are in the tail end of the pandemic and life will go back to normal really very, very soon. But bottom line is, eventually you're gonna have to leave the house, even if it is just to go get groceries. Well, this time of the year when it's cold, one of the best things you can invest in is outerwear. And one of the best outerwear out there is a top coat. So in this video, I'm gonna give you five things to look for when purchasing a top coat. First thing to look for is the size of the overcoat. Now, this is one garment where you do not wanna get it true to size. You don't want it to be too snug on your body. Rather, you wanna go up a size or a couple sizes. And the reason for that being is that the overcoat is a larger piece in your layering. So whether you're wearing a thick sweater or a thick hoodie or even a suit, the overcoat has to be big enough to fit on top of that comfortably. Second thing to look for is what the outer shell of the overcoat is made from, so the fabric of the overcoat. Of course, with it being cold out, you want to go with your thicker fabric. So your wools, your tweeds, if you can afford it, cashmere, alpaca, or any kind of fur type of overcoat, those can get very expensive. The more common and more affordable ones that you will find are your wools. So the third thing to look for is the length of the overcoat. Now, here's where you use your discretion. Ideally, you want the length to be right at about knee level or slightly above knee level. But again, use your discretion because the length of the overcoat should be proportional to your height proportion. So you don't want it to be too long on you or too short. And this may be a case where you might just have to go custom if you want it at the perfect length. The fourth thing to look for is the insulation of the overcoat. Of course, it's an overcoat, so you want it to keep you warm first and foremost. Typically, what you will see out there with your average overcoat, the inner lining is made from polyester. You will see some out there made from faux fur, and these are more on the affordable end. So if you wanna have the inner lining to be more natural fabrics, like cashmere, you might have to pay a little bit more. The fifth thing to look for is the closure of the overcoat. Now, for me, there's nothing more stylish than a peak lapel double-breasted overcoat. Even though I do have a single-breasted one and a lot of guys prefer that, just my personal preference, I will go with the double-breasted over the single-breasted any day of the week. The overlapping of the coat, it not only complements and flatters my body, but it also gives me extra warmth. Now, a top coat is one of those garments you do not want to shortchange yourself on. Like a white tee, a regular white tee, sure, go to Target, go to Walmart, get you a pack, very cheap. A top coat, though, you gotta invest in it. You gotta dish out a few more dollars because this is something you want to last a few winters and a few falls. Take what I'm wearing, for example. I bought this 3 years ago and it still fits me. Yeah, my arms have gotten bigger in the last 3 years. Might feel a little bit of tightness there, but only when I do this. And you get that with any structured garment. Anytime you move your arms, you're gonna feel a little bit of tightness there. But it's not so tight and uncomfortable that I don't wear it. Of course, I still wear it, it still fits me. As far as where can you get top coats? Gap, Old Navy, I'm sure Asos has some, J.Crew has some. I'm putting links down below to really nice top coats that you guys can check out. This one and the navy blue one that I got it from a company called Southern Gents. Again, I'm gonna put a link down below so you guys can check them out. And the brown one, the one with the faux fur, I actually got that from a thrift store for $15. So that's another place for you guys to check out where you can get really nice top coats at very discounted prices. Yeah, I know it's faux fur, but still, I couldn't pass up on that. 15 bucks for that, I had to get it. All right, guys, thank you for watching this video. I appreciate it. Leave your comments down below. Let me know your thoughts about top coats. How many do you have? How long have you had them? And if you agree with me, do you agree that this is one of those garments in your wardrobe that you cannot shortchange yourself on? You have to invest in it. Let me know your thoughts down below. Like, subscribe, all that good stuff. I will catch you guys in the next video. And until then, stay fly, stay fit.